everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to talk more about the files and the strings, and as we saw in a previous tutorial, I named about the, or I used the fprintf function, which has arguments like the file you want write anything, and the format and a message or a character, and what you want write. And we have also function fscanf, and we are going to from which file, in which file you are going to scan with which format and put in which address in memory. I am going to show you the previous program. I have instead of using loop for that to initialize of those elements in an array to zero, I have only declared them or initialized them directly as zero, and I have a counter for uppercase letters and a counter for lowercase letters, and I have used the same files efp pointer and pointed ufp, and I opened the in file, which is located in the v1 directory, and it is that program we are using and running. And I am going to open another out file, and if it doesn't exist in the directory, it's going to automatically create it. And I am going to use while c, get c efp is not equal end of file. I can change this one to while sf scanf efp with the format d as integer and put it in address c, which is defined up there, is equal 1. It means that we are not end of file. Then we are going to use that condition. If c is a capital letter between a and z, then increase the number of capital letters of C minus A and put it there. And I have made six columns, and after six columns I have used a new line, and I have used fprintf. It means that write inside the file with that format. With that format, I have used C, a character, and I have used the number of the items of them. And the character is here, is a plus I, and it counts from a to I, and the capital letters count. And then I rewind to the beginning of the in file, and I am going to search of lowercase, and I am increment the lowercase items, and I am using the same six columns, and I am going to use the same in output file. I am going to select and write the letters and the item of aqua in the file. Then I am going to close the files and I am going to run. Now it is run, and I am going to my directory and I open out file, and as you see we have those items and everything is correct. I am going to delete it. To run again to show you that it automatically is created and it is correct. Okay. In this chapter we have talked about the fscanf and the fprintf, and we have also sscanf and sprintf. Sscanf is a constant char, We are going to put get scan or copy from character S with different format and put it in address in the memory, and we are going to use sprintf in the sprintf in a constant char pointed s. We are going to write to the s with constant char format, pointed control string, and from the variables, from any variables in memory. To use these, I am going to make another program. I am going to make this as comments. Some places has comments. Even here. Okay. am going to include studio and int main, and I'm going to declare char string 1 a vector 1, 2, 3 go. They are as characters, not numbers, and they must be in the code because it is a string. And I am going to use a string 2, another vector of 100 elements, and I am going to use temp with 100 elements as well, and I am going to use integer a, b, and c, and I am going to use scanf from string et, and I am going to use with format ddd and one string, not character, one string, because go is two characters, and I am going to put it in address A, address B, and address C. Then I am going to use printf string string 2. In string 2 with format s, format s, format d, format d, format d, new line, and I am going to read temp a, b, and c, and I am going to print f with format s string 2, and I am going to use return 0 and close the clammer. And I am going to compile. It is something wrong. It is warning 18. Oh, it is here. Seven. And also address temp, of course, address temp. And 11 is okay because it was so. I compile it again. And I have to return. And it is warnings inside comments. It is the view. And I am going to compile it again, and argument 6. Argument is scanf. It is a string. Okay, because the temp is already a pointer and it is already array, and an array is a pointer. I don't need use address temp only temp. I must use it. Now it is okay, and I am going to run. Yes, I am going to take copy the variables 1 as integer to A, 2 as integer to B, 3 as integer to C, and go as a string to temp. And I am going to write in this array and string temp, which is go, another string temp, which is go, and also three integers A, B, C, which is 1, 2, 3. And what I am going to take in this string, it is go, go, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Now we are going to see if you talk about the strings. About the strings and their variables, and I don't know where it is. Just a second. A string conversions. We have a function, string 2D, which means that convert an string to integer, and it is very good to convert to a value. And we are going to have a O2F which convert a string to a double or float value. A to E converts an string to integer, and A to L, L converts string to a long value, and A to L converts only an string to L format, long, and string 2D, it is the same as A to E, I, A to I, and another functions in string handling is string handling functions. And we have a function string cat, which concatenates the string s1 and string s2, that copies string 2 and append it to string 1. Means that you have a string 1 and the indicator points to the end of string 1 and put the string 2. We have string char, which searches for the character C in string and return a character. And string compare is going to compare those two strings, and when it finds a character, an equal characters, it's going to give the place, the number of its place as a result. string call also compares two string S8 and S2, S1 and S2, and returns a value of the value of the place in the strings. And string copy, it's going to copy string S2 to string 1. It replaces, it's not appending, it replaces. And string len, it's going to give you the length of string S and returns the length of the number of characters in strings. And string encat is going to concatenate or append S2 in S1 after the end position. A string encompare is going to search in S1 the string S2 from the end position. String and copy also are going to copy the S1 in S2 after the end position. And the break is going to searching for the first character in S8 that matches S2. If the search is successful, the address of character found in S1 is returned. Otherwise, null is returned. And string searches in S1 the first occurrence of S2 in character. These functions are very useful in files or in a meaning. For example, if you want to find the string D, THE in one file or in one phrases, you are going to use that string, and it returns the items of S2 character or string in S1. String took is very good when you are going to search in S1 the first character of S2 in string, and you are going to put the split string. For example, I have this example and I'm going to put it here. I am going to end the program here and I am going to use the this here. And I am going to run this program and you are going to see what is happening. I have declared S1 and a string with unknown items of element, an array of character which is an string, and I have initialized. This is an example, and I have declared another string or another array of characters with a space, comma, and semicolon, and string, and space, and I have declared a pointer of character p, and I have written printf. I want to use the double quote. I want to write the double quote and an string and close double quote, which is a slash double quote, string slash double quote, and this is the format, and I am going to use a string took s1 and s2. It's going to search the space, comma, and semicolon in this phrase, in this string. And as soon as it finds the first one, it's going to print the result. And I am going to use p equal string took. We must use first this one, and then you are going to put p is equal string took null, and s2 is not equal null, which means that you have phrase yet. The first thing it appear here, it is the space, and it is in s2. Then it has find it, and it is going to take in this function, it's going to have this one, and it is going to print p, and after that it is going, because it is while, it's going to find the second space, and it's going to have is, and it's going to find comma, and it is this, and it's going to find the space, and it is this, and it is going, and so on. We are going to run this program. Okay, because we have used a string copy, it must include string.h, which is this function all inside there. Now I'm going to compile it again. Now it is okay, and I am going to run. Yes, it's coming. The first thing is coming this, and then is, and then and then example. It's going to put away all the spaces and comma and semicolon, and I haven't used new line, but I can use new line that you can see. It's going to take the first string after the space, and the pointer is there, and it's going to take the string after the space, and it's going to take the strings after comma and space, and it is and it's going to take the string after spaces, and it is then, and it's going to take the string after space, semicolon, which is empty. And I'm going to run again. And it is. This is an example. Okay. It is I must see if it is more things I should talk about. No, it was all. It was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.